In fact, I find the newspapers and the TV, particularly the news, very, very amusing. You know, they're real jokes to watch. And in a way, you're looking at these guys and they're going to talk about terrorism. And yet, here are the world's two greatest terrorists sitting in conference. Two people in the world who have the world wondering, when is the end going to come? When is one of them going to go off and drop a bomb that is going to destroy the life of man and perhaps life on earth, period? The very fact that they are seen as powerful people, the very fact that the world sat in intense attention when they met, is symbolic of the fact that they are holding the world in a state of terror. And that we are frightened that they may, for some reason or other, let loose the great power that they have under their hands. And yet they have nerve enough to talk about terrorism as if it belongs to another people. And yet these are the people many of us want to claim that we want our children to be just like. These are the people we want our children to share a piece of the pie with. And yet these are the peoples whose very weapons are weapons of death. These are the people who represent death in the world. One of the things I recognized when I went through the graduate schools, and that struck me again and again and again, and that was this idea that these people are dead. They're not alive. And dead people are deadly. What kind of civilization can it be when the more civilized you become, the more deadly you become? How can you justify that as civilization? We as a people then have to recognize that there must be an alternative to this kind of being. That the idea of our people is not to share equality with these people. Because the system that they represent is one that in and of itself should be rejected. What kind of education, and the brother wonders sometimes why I don't want to be called doctor, I don't want to be called this and that. In a sense, I think if we think about it very closely, we should be very hesitant about giving ourselves those titles that are conferred upon us by these other people and what they so-called represent. Because we have to recognize that the educated individual is the craziest of all individuals. That the educated individual is the most dangerous of all individuals. When this world comes to its end, it will not be brought to an end by the muggers on the streets, ladies and gentlemen. It will not be brought to an end by the drug addicts, by the street prostitutes, by the youth gangs. It's going to be brought to an end by people with PhD degrees. It's going to be brought to an end by people who studied physics and mathematics, who spent 15 and 20 and 30 years in school. It's going to be brought to an end by people who live in nice clipped lawns with houses on the corner, with neat hedges, two-car garages, nice little well-spoken children, the people who send their kids to private school. And one morning they'll go off to work and give their wives a nice little bourgeois kiss. And then they'll go down and sit in front of the console of their computer and proceed to blow themselves up along with the rest of the world. what kind of education is it that leads to these kind of people, ladies and gentlemen? These people are being educated into madness. A real Afrocentric education would not educate people in such a way that they then develop tools of death and destruction, that they become the endpoint of a destructive procedure. When you must recognize then that these very people you bow and dip to and defer to, these very so-called experts, are the people who are going to take you directly to hell. Because you are responding to them not in terms of truth, not in terms of what they're really saying, but in terms of their symbols of authority. And because they lay these symbols of authority on you, they can tell you any kind of nonsense, and you're ready to believe it. And because they threaten you and intimidate you with their degrees and with their so-called learning, you're not willing to follow your own common sense and question what they have to say and where they're going and what they're doing. And you don't have sense enough then to say, wait a minute, if you are so well educated, if you are so liberal, if you are so perceptive, if you are so concerned, why are you making weapons of death that will destroy you, your children, and the futures of mankind? Why are you then living in the laps of luxury, having far more wealth and money than you could ever use, while millions and millions of my people are starving and dying the world over? So we must recognize then that these kind of people cannot lay a correct perception of reality upon us as a people. And we must recognize that the very educated among them are the very ones who are responsible to a great degree for creating the distorted reality we face today. We have to recognize that knowledge in and of itself does not represent the salvation of mankind.